Hi everyone, I'm Hasterius. Today, like I said, I will make a video about top smallest dragons in How to Change Your Dragon. Well, and after a close look, I discovered 3 small dragon species, lots of interesting information, and they are gathered in 2 famous gangs. So this video will be top 3 gangs of little dragons in How to Change Your Dragon. Let's start. 1. Night Terror. Dragons can be strong in many ways. For example, Night Fury has speed, Skrill can control thunders, the Wildebeest can control other dragons, Shellfire has good higher power. Today I will introduce to you an extremely small, extremely scary dragon, but it is not dangerous. It's the Night Terror, the terrors of the night. Night Terror looks like a bat. Each individual Night Terror is black in color, except for the Alpha. They have 2 small horn-like legs on top of their nose. They also appear to have a short tail with 4 short, thin spikes attached at the ends. Information: Class Stalker. Size: small. Length: 0.91 meters. Wingspan: 1.52 meters. Weight: 6.35 kilograms. Ability: Night Terrors can play puzzle game very well. Night Terrors are able to fly close together in order to form the shapes of larger, more terrifying dragons for protection. This behavior resembles that of European starling or certain schools of fish, who fly or scream together in order to appear larger so as to scare off predators. Each swarm has an alpha who controls its fellow dragons and instruct them to form certain formations and often test the spot of the dragon's eyes. Though the speed of a Night Terror is not comparable to that of Night Fury, they are fast enough to maintain the shape of the dragon form. What's more interesting is that they can make this form a lifelike motion. Night Terror's power and breath fire were not strong, probably just enough to let you light a cigarette. However, if the whole team fire, it can also create a giant fireball. Night Terror is very smart. Any creature that knows how to make puzzles is not intelligent. Weakness: by capturing the Alpha Night Terror, you could probably take down the whole flock. In addition, the strength of each member of the flock is not high, so when they go along, they can only hide or become prey for other dragons. Conclusion: the nightmare is small dragons, the power is not much. In return, they are very intelligent, can take advantage of the fear of other dragons to fight and protect the territory. Bonus: Night Terror can be trained. It is extremely suitable if you want to smoke without having money to buy lighters. Fire Terrors live inside the volcano of Caldera Cave, and they are very protective of Eruptodon eggs and will do anything to make sure that they hatch. 2. Smothering Smoke Breath. Based on its appearance and the ability to release smoke, you can call it the nickname Pipe. Smothering Smoke Breath is a dragon with very little information. They were never known by any Vikings until they met Hiccup and Putlitz. They accidentally discovered the existence of this dragon. Information: Class: Mystery. Size: small. Height: 1.6 meters. Length: 1.83 meters. Wingspan: 3.05 meters. Weight: 63.5 kilograms. The Smothering Smoke Breath is a bit larger than a Night Terror, with the flatter body, but it is entirely gray. The head and mouth are almost as big as its body, and it has no discernible neck. It has short, stubby legs and a wingspan equivalent to over twice its body length, though in its debut, its body was longer than its wingspan. Its tail is long, thin, and very spiky. Smothering Smoke Breath can create a veil of smoke to hide from enemies or victims. They excrete deep dense fog from their skins. In addition, their fire also tends to create a great deal of subsiding smoke as it is released. Because of this ability, it was thought to be a kind of fog monster and became legendary. Although they usually breathe the smoke, Smoke breath can breathe the very hot fire, since it is capable of melting metal in a matter of moments. A large swarm may appear as a strange smoke cloud. Smoke breath packs have the habit of collecting treasures and shiny things to merge them together to create their nests in order to defend themselves from other dragons. They often go to extremes to collect treasures, as shown when they unform the cloud of smoke and chase the riders for their medals. Smothering smoke breaths are fast flyers, for they are able to easily evade and outmaneuver humans as well as other dragons, even including Night Fury. Their strength is through their numbers. When smoke breath alone isn't strong enough, but smoke breaths are social creatures, entire swarms can lift whole ships filled with cargo out of the ocean, can flounder all the precious metals from Viking ships and nearby villages. It can be affirmed that their ability to work in teams is extremely good. Winishes. Just like the other small-sized dragons, they are also extremely vulnerable when they are by themselves, when smoke breath alone isn't enough to keep themselves concealed. 3. Speed Stinger. Speed Stinger is a dragon that cannot fail to mention in the mini-sized dragon of How to Train Your Dragon. Small but extremely agile and dangerous. The Speed Stinger is a swift, flightless dragon which resembles a featherless theropod dinosaur, particularly a velociraptor. Speed Stingers have muscular back legs with two claws in the front, one in the back. Some parts of speed stingers have great talents which allow them to run across water, island hopping. Average speed stingers are aqua-colored, while the leader has red stripes, highlights, and is slightly larger than the rest of the pack. It commands the respect and the attention of the pack. Information: class sharp, size small, height 2.16 meters, length 4.88 meters, weight 272.2 kilograms. Intelligence. Speed Stingers have shown to be very intelligent, as they work in packs and can plan attacks. These attacks are usually planned by their leader. Speed Stingers have excellent and powerful night vision, as they can see perfectly at night and even through a minor snowstorm. Speed Stingers are among the most dangerous and aggressive dragons. They are famous with their stingers. However, their stings cannot penetrate metal or thick wood. Young stingers and adults are very accurate with their stingers. The sharp stingers on the end of its barbed tail contains a powerful venom that can paralyze a victim entirely in just one sting. The sting eventually wears off, some in hours, others in days, depending on the amount of venom injected. Another lesson: speed stinger's venom is not fully developed, but just it can paralyze an entire victim on one sting. Instead, the venom only works around the area of the sting, leaving the rest of the body movable and operational. Due to the high energy of their running, speed stingers have highly colored skin that can protect them from fire and make them impervious to arrows and spears. Their speed produces plenty of friction and heat, thus they have thick hides. Speed stingers have high stamina, as they are able to run very long distances and hunt down their prey without any sign of fatigue. Speed stingers lack any flame juices. This is because all the internal flame energy goes to its powerful legs, which gives its speed, agility, and the capacity to jump high. With high speed on their side, they are the fastest land runner of all dragons. They are fast enough to be almost invisible while traveling at high speed. As one of the most agile dragons, their speed allows them to gain enough velocity to run up walls and even run upside down on ceilings for a short period of time. They can even keep up with some strike-class dragons while doing ground battles. Speed stingers are very stealthy, as they are able to use their speed to get around Vikings or dragons easily without being noticed until they attack. The lead speed stinger is the largest speed stinger. It has been known to be the most aggressive, agile, strongest, and intelligent. A lead stinger has been seen to go against the Night Fury, which shows its aggression. It is able to dodge the Night Fury's attacks with its speed and agility. The weakness of the speed stinger is obvious.
they can fly no attack at long range. Besides, they can be paralyzed by their own venom. However, despite not being able to fly or attack at long range, Speed Stinger is still extremely dangerous, especially for humans.
So the content about top 3 gangs of little dragons in How to Change Your Dragon is over. The next video will be the top 4 biggest dragon gangs. Please subscribe to not miss that video. Now goodbye and see you.